The Chancellor, Professor Owen, and of course our teachers in my home, they are well known. The Vice Chancellor, Professor Kua, my first chairman of the council, Dr. NAAMARA, members of the University Council, members of the faculty, members from Nairobi, and I'm very happy to see the gentleman on which I was meeting last week, so I'm so glad you were able to make it. Academics from NAAMARA University and from all the other universities, students, colleagues, and well wishers of NAAMARA University. Thank you very much all for coming. My name is Warren NAAMARA and I'm the chairman of NAAMARA University. I don't teach, but these people were very new. I decided to ask me to come and give the keynote speech. And I wasn't terribly sure about what to do. But they also gave me a topic. They did it in conservative. You know, how unfair people can be. But in my other life, I used to live some kind of life in one form or another as a researcher, as a teacher. So sometimes I probably could dust myself and do something if I can at all. And, but if I make a mistake, don't blame me for whatever work I have done. My topic was the evolution of HIV and non-communicable diseases. Now, this is a very big topic. We could sit here and talk about it for the next 1 week, and some of you could write your PhD thesis out of this and master's. But I decided to structure my speech or my keynote address as the following. I want to review the epidemic as of today. What is the HIV epidemic as of today? And I want to tell you that in my other earlier life, I worked for the United Nations in enabling NAAMARA as the country director. And so that's why you see these slides with the UNAIDS logo. Once a UN staff, always a UN staff. And we use many of these slides, and we have a lot of data. So I decided to dust some of my own slides, get some new ones, and be able to talk to you about the disease of the AIDS epidemic as it is today. So what is the non-communicable disease burden today? I'll try to do as much as I can, but I hope I will succeed. And then, what are the linkages of these two conditions, non-communicable diseases, HIV and AIDS, and specific emphasis on sub-Saharan Africa and Uganda in particular? So what is the status of the epidemic today? I don't want to read this slide, but where is the red thing? I want you to pay particular attention to East and Southern Africa. This is adults and children estimated to be living with HIV are 20 million, a staggering 20 million people. Half of the Ugandan population in the world is living with HIV. Now, this has no relevance, as we shall see later. But how do we compare very unfavorably with the rest of the world? Latin America 1.9, West and Central Africa 5, and I worked in Central in West Africa for some time. There are reasons why there are substantial differences. Very substantial differences. And I can tell you right away that one of the biggest substantial differences is circumcision. The bulk of West Africa is 99% circumcised. The bulk of East and Southern Africa is less than 99% circumcised. In fact, far less, maybe right now. And that has a lot of relevance in terms of HIV infection. So, what are the estimated number of adults and children? You know, the incidence in 2018. This is where the epidemic is being fueled. From the in the Southeastern and Southern Africa, 800,000 new infections in this year. Now, that is the driver of the epidemic, actually. That's the driver of the epidemic. But compared to North America, which is only 68, and the people giving us the money to prevent HIV infection, we get infected, we get less infected, we bring the drugs, we buy them, as you all know. What about the estimated deaths after 2018? Look at how many people later, the complicated, there are many reasons why they die, but the non-communicable diseases are part of the biggest problems in these patients. And what about children? Children, of course, you can imagine, since we are highly transmitting infection, you must also be having sex. If you have sex, you get children. And so, the children under 15 years living with the HIV, the group of them, 1.1 million people, as of 2018. These are the children we are producing. You remember the first slide where Eastern Southern Africa have got more infection? We are still having these children. These ones, you see, 1.1 million. Keep looking at the total figures because you get there. And then the expected number of children newly infected, incidence in the under 15. This is the fear of the epidemic. And these children have got chronic conditions, either communicable conditions, communicable diseases, or non-communicable diseases. In fact, for you people who are in the NAAMARA, you already notice that any child who has got HIV infection, the first sentence is that since this child was born, she or he has developed pneumonia, coughing, pneumonia, and all sorts of other infections. Sorry. So, this adapted it because the part of it. Yeah, we have reached to there. So, I wanted you to look at the distribution of the infection 15 to 49 years of age. And I want you to pay particular emphasis to this middle slide, East and Southern Africa. I keep referring to Eastern and Southern Africa because that's where the margin of disease is. But look at the blue. This is the general population globally. But in Eastern and Southern Africa, look at the remaining population. The general population is 75% new infection. This has got a lot of relevance because if we are going to program anything, we have to look at the general population rather than pay specific emphasis. The people who inject the drugs, gay men and other, and bisexual clients of sex work. That's it. But if you come to West Africa, you might want to consider clients of sex work. And I want to tell you that the West African infection is driven by the propensity spent. The money available per person in West Africa is perhaps responsible for this terrible infection. Because almost any infection, rather any sex in West Africa, is actually a transaction of sex. You buy your sex even when you are with your wife. Either you take them to
Either you take them to another, then we are buying them. You buy them, we are on the field, and the next day, we are buying a man.
So, the result is that there is sufficient evidence of the difference in this epidemic, and later on, that's what influences the non-communicable diseases and of course the communicable diseases. But pay special attention to the general population. The general population, one, not sex worker, gay men, drug users, or sex partners in the population. We are responsible for the drive of the epidemic in this country and in Southern Africa. I put in this slide because I just wanted to demonstrate one very simple thing. Look at HIV prevalence in the what we have called in the subnational level. These are basically surveys. It's like Costa Rica has conspired to give us the worst. Look at the Southern Africa. Look at Uganda and Ethiopia. And look at the West Africa. The information may not be available here, but here in West Africa, the infection is this. And we have known this for a very long time, by the way, it's not new. But I just wanted to know, I just wanted you to know that the evidence is still ready in our region. If you are going to make any programs for you who are in programming or in the clinics, prepare for the big show. It is still coming. So what are the trends